And it's a big April. $29.216. This dog is quite fierce.
Be careful.
Yeah, it bites. So this lump, I think the dog was scratching, so the owner came and I treated the skin disease, which has now fully recovered. Skin disease.
It's not better for his toe.
He wants it. Did the owner want it? Skin disease, but apparently after 4 weeks, the skin disease has gone away, because you can't operate when there's skin disease. It's a ringworm. And then now there's no more skin disease, so the owner agrees to get the dog, the lump here, which you see in the other video, removed. And only thing is that this dog is a fierce dog. And so the owner has to muzzle him before we can operate on him. Now, this is most likely a fat lump. And what was used?
Amitriptyline,
ketamine, and gas anesthetic?
Yes.
Maybe a bit of gas, yeah. 8 years old, 0.4 plus 0.5 IV. Now, these stitches are dissolvable, so there's no need to come back for stitch removal. So what I do is give the painkillers, and we have a ruler to show the width. There, show the width of the. It's about how many centimeter diameter? It's about 3.5, and 3.5. Yeah, about that. And this is a subcutaneous lump here. Whether it causes him to scratch or not, I don't know. I think his problem was skin infection plus scratching. Okay, so we check his inner sac. Have you checked? We check his inner sac before he wakes up, because you can see there's a sign here that he has been also having inner sac problems. So we quickly do while he's still asleep. And the ears we checked already. Check the ears already. Now we have a quick check on the teeth. The owner not interested in doing the teeth, but still we have a quick check. Okay, wait, you come inside first. Let me check on this side. And now must sit the dog properly. Then we can do the expression of the inner sac. Let me check the teeth. Teeth looks pretty good for this age, 8 years old. So it's quite good teeth. Yeah. Now let's sit the dog properly first. Why? You don't sit properly. Sit properly, then you can express. Is there a lot of oil? Normally we sit the dog. And then, no, see this side, sir?
No.
Wait, I just hold first. Okay, this side, sir. The positioning is important now, okay. So whether he want to do histology or not, it's up to the owner. Sometimes to save money, they don't want to do any histology. Okay, wait, let me come this side first. To see anything come up. Okay, there's some oil. Okay, so ready, pull the tail up. Pull the tail high up. Now you can see it. You can see this is the sign of inner sacculitis. Okay, the oil. You can see my hand is already full of the dark oil. So be quite squirt under your face. And so we'll do the dog a favor by expressing it. Expressing this, another tumor here actually, but this is water. You will just close up your cover. Cover before it shoot out, yeah, because it shoot out into your face or your shirt. Yeah. So there's still more, you see. So this is just to do the owner a favor, and the dog also. This dog bites, so owner won't be able to do it. And I think as a vet, you have the responsibility to do as much as possible for the dog while he's under sedation, especially those very fierce dogs. This crossbred is fierce and bites. Pull the tail up, and there's a strong smell. And what we do is we will cut off the warts as well, which is quite a simple thing. Let's just cut off, snip off. And now I can check there's no more. There is no more. No more impaction. Okay. So that is good. So check the ears as well. Have a quick look, put the cotton bud, come check the ears. because these dogs seldom have a chance of veterinary examination due to being fierce. I can't recall that he was fierce when I did his skin disease, but then, okay, put further deep in, it's very dirty. Okay, someone the other side, deep in, is it dirty? Yeah, so you put some ear drops and then clean the ears for the owner, for the dog. Muzzle first, just in case it bites, and then these are all safety precaution. And we don't just do one thing here, which is removal of the subcutaneous lump. It also will help the poor dog to have a general ear cleaning plus inner sac. Teeth is okay. This 8 years old dog probably never see a vet for many years because normally owners don't send the dog for treatment because this is a crossbreed. Crossbreed normally they don't just bother. Yeah. Now the tongue looks cyanotic, but actually that is the color of the tongue. Some dogs have darker tongue. You see my assistant cleaner ears. Yeah, as many drops as possible and drop very hard to peel the debris. That's good. So my hand got this smell of inner sac. Yeah. Okay. So everything is cleaned up for him, and I think the owner will be happier. At least the dog will be happier if not the owner. Yeah. Okay. See, my assistant likes to use all this. This is the old way of doing it. Yeah. But this is traditionally we use this way. Yeah. But for me, I just use ear irrigation, just flush, clear the dirt and finish off. Yeah. But each person has his own way. This way is one way. Just use syringe and syringe off. Everything will come out. And because the dog is under anesthetic, that's the fastest way and also the best way. Syringe and irrigate. Yeah. But everybody has his own ideas. So now this one we will have to quickly wait. This one just snip it off will do. Come. While he's under anesthetic. Oh, you want to do this one first? Okay? You do this one first. Do the other ear first.
Which one?
The ear first before you forget. Yeah. Do the ear first before you wake up. I don't think he wake up so early. Now there's an antecedent to bring him up, but we don't need it. Yeah. Okay. Now she clean up first. Now apparently this dog has a severe skin disease 12 weeks ago. Yeah, this is the best way, and all the debris will come out. Yeah. Normally I squirt about 5 times. Yeah. Oh, okay. But every person has his own idea. So, groomer will put powder in, and other things. Yeah. So, as long as it works, that's okay. Now you can see that the tongue, a bit purplish, but some of them are born with it. But you can see actually, it's not cyanotic. You can see that is due to pigmentation of the tongue. He's still asleep, so you can still have some time to, but you're gonna wake up soon sometime, and then so histology, I'll ask the owner whether he wants or not. Okay, so the other side, so irrigate the ear. No, the other side, so it's faster than washing, because washing might not be which way. This way, if it turn, irrigate their side also, and because the dog is under sedation, otherwise it's very difficult to do, he'll bite. Okay, so basically there's nothing much. This is the sign of inner sacculitis. Okay, it's not ringworm, especially you see bilateral, two-sided. Early on you can see a video of a very inner sac abscess in another dog. Now these type of cases, normally we just sedate them rather than squirt them out because it's painful, especially inner sac abscess. Normally my philosophy is just to sedate them rather than let them suffer by squirting them with a very small water. Just snip off a do. Yeah. Then nothing, then a bit of potassium permanganate, brief cotton bud or tissue, cotton bud. just in case it grows bigger, in case it grows bigger, this doesn't really need any stitching or anything. Just cauterize it. Yeah. Okay. So this dog should be more comfortable after this procedure of ear cleaning and the removal of the lump here. He's been scratching using his left feet to do that, and that's why he's got all those skin diseases. You can see there some bacteria, ringworm actually. Those are the black spots of ringworm, quite a lot. Some are pigmented, some are natural. Ringworm is very common in Singapore dogs due to the humidity of the country, tropical climate, dampness. You can see the ringworm cured. You see the white patches? These are the healing ringworm skin spots. So that's the end of this case, April 29, 2016, Toa Payoh Vets, Singapore.